complex number. Today's our topic is a complex number from 11th class, because we discuss about the complex number. Before of this, first we discuss about the number system, because complex number is also a part of the number system. And before of this, first we discuss about your previous class study, like you study about the natural number. Okay, natural number, it is denoted by n. And natural numbers, they are including like 1, 2, 3, up to so on infinity. And then whole numbers including 0 with natural number, that is whole numbers. And then integers, it means all whole numbers you add on with plus minus sign, that is an integer. And then rational number. Okay, rational number, it means you add on a number in the form of p by q, and where q is not equal to 0. And then irrational numbers. Okay, so this is the group for the real numbers. This all including, like here we have natural number, then we have whole number, then integers. Okay, then this is the part of rational, and also we include irrational number, and all including this part is called real number. This is the group of numbers is called the real number, in which natural number, whole number, integers, rational number, irrational number, this is the bunch of all numbers they are including in the number systems. But we discuss about the only the real numbers. Okay, and then outside you draw, this is the completely out of this you write down, this is the complex number in which you include. Okay, so this is circle. In circle, inside all the numbers they are including in the complex number. But first here we study, because everyone know about the number, so first you basically understand about the number system. In 10th class, first I will write down the general form of the complex number, that is x plus I y. Okay, here we introduce a general form of the complex number. We wrote it in form of z equal to x plus I y. X and y are the real, because here we write down the form of like real numbers. Okay, so and then now here we introduce this I, and I means here iota. And what do you mean by iota? Why here this symbol is called iota? Because we studied the 10th class, we study about the quadratic equation. Okay, in quadratic equation there are the, you use like general form of the quadratic equation, x square plus bx plus c equal to 0. And now here you use the formula like minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Okay, and now this inside value is called discriminant. You do not divide, denote it by d, that is b square minus 4ac. Okay, and now you define the nature of roots. Okay, how you define the nature of roots? Nature of roots is defined by the discriminant. If your discriminant is greater than 0, if your discriminant equal to 0, if your discriminant less than 0, if your discriminant greater than equal to 0, or write down less than equal to 0. Okay, so these are the nature of the quadratic equations. In here you write down like roots are real. Okay, and here roots are equal. Here you write down roots are imaginary. Okay, roots are imaginary. And now here roots are real and distinct and equal. Here you write down imaginary roots are equal and imaginary. So these are all the nature of the square roots. First, this is the condition for roots are imaginary. And what do you mean by the imaginary here? So now you define the concept for the imaginary. You write down d is less than 0. So why you write down d is less than 0? Because of, you find out the square root sign. Like inside the square root sign you have the negative term. If you have the negative term, then you directly write down roots are not real. So roots are not real. So how you find the roots? Okay, so now here we discuss discuss about the imaginary roots, or we said it not real roots. So now here we
okay,
here we consider like the quadratic equation x square plus 1 equal to 0. And another side here we consider x square minus 9 equal to 0. Okay, so I think you know that x square plus 1 equal to 0 and x square minus 9. So x square equal to 9, then you write down x equal to 3 or minus 3. So this is the answer for x equal to 3 or minus 3. But here we write down x square equal to minus 1, then x equal to under root minus 1. Then we said that this is not solvable because your inside value is negative, and then if your discriminant is less than 0, then your roots are not real. So now here we introduce the concept for the iota. Now inside all value, this is called like you have inside of minus 1 with negative sign, then it is called iota. So denote this symbol, you write down I equal to under root minus 1, and it is called iota. Okay, this symbol is called iota. Iota means you write down here under root minus 1. This is the square root of minus 1. You write down like I, and I means here iota, and iota that their value is under root of minus 1. And then any negative value inside a square root you write down in form of the I, then you find out your roots. So this chapter also called complex number and the quadratic equation, because here we describe about the complex number and the quadratic equation. So first concept is what? Any quadratic equation having the roots are not real, then you find out with the help of iota. You write down if under root minus 1 is there, then in place of under root minus 1 you put I. Okay, and then here we write down some properties related to the iota. If you have I equal to under root minus 1 and then squaring on both the sides, so I square under root minus 1 of square. So you write down here I square, then square sign, so root are removed, then value of I square is minus 1. Okay, so you got the value like minus 1, then in place of minus 1 you write down directly I square. Okay, then we find the value for I cube. I cube, it means you write down I square into R. Okay, I square just you write down like minus 1, and now also you put here I. So value of I cube is minus R. Okay, so you replace the value for I cube. I cube is minus I, and similarly you continue for the I to the power 4. I to the power 4, which is I square into I square. Okay, so you put minus 1 into minus 1, and minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1. So I to the power 4 is plus 1. So now here you understand about the concept for the I to the power 4. Because every term of I, they are multiple of 4, all values are multiple of 4, their answer always be 1. Because now here we got the value of I, like here 1. Similarly, you write down for the formula for I, if your I to the power 4, then your result will be always 1, not depend which power is given, which number is given, and directly they are all multiple of 4. So here we write down the general formula for the multiple of 4. R to the power 4 into m, any integer value multiple of 4, always you write down answer 1, and then 4m plus 1. Okay, then any value, any power is given, but their remainder is 1, rest of value resulted like I. And similarly, I to the power 4m plus 2 means I square, your answer is minus 1. And I to the power 4m plus 3, you have minus I. So there are 4 results. Any value with respect to multiple of 4, their result will be 1. I to the power 4m plus 1, like I. And now similarly, I to the power 4m plus 2 is minus 1. And similarly, I to the power 4m plus 3 equal to minus 1. How it is possible? Now just give me write down like, you know that my 4m here. So just give me explain. With the concept of law of exponent, I to the power 4m. Okay, so you write down here like I to the power 4 of m, and I to the power 4 is 1, and 1 to the power m, I think you know that is 1. Similarly, Similarly, I to the power 4m plus 1. So again here we use the concept of law of exponent 4m into I. Because 4m plus 1, so you divide into two parts, because base are same, then power will be added. So power will be added, then your base are you add all in the separate form. So this I to the power 4m, just here we prove that is 1 and 1 into I, so your result is I. Similarly, here we write down like I to the power 4m plus 2. Similarly, you add on in the same way 4m into I square. So again here we add on I to the power 4m is 1, and now here I square is minus 1. So your answer is minus 1. Similarly, now the fourth formula, you add on here like I to the power 4m plus 3. Similarly, here we add on 4m into I to the power 3. So I to the power 4m, just here we have to show that 1, and now I cube, here we add on like I cube, that is I to the power 3 is minus I. So directly you add on here minus I, so your resultant value is minus I. Okay, so now here we describe all four formula. If your power I, because first here we describe in the complex number, you know the concept of iota. Because iota is very important part or role play in complex number. So first here we write down, are we solving the concept on behalf of the iota, some examples, they are written with the, some powers, and then how you simplify the value of iota in different way, in different operation form. Okay, then here we write down some examples, they are written with the I, and now we evaluate the value of I, like we simplify in form of I and some powers, maybe they are 12, 21, 42, 53, 96, there are two questions and different powers are given, like iota having the, some exponent or maybe integral part, so you simplify and then write down the answer. So first here we write down here like I to the power 12, okay, I to the power 12, and now first this 12 you write down in multiple of 4, so you divide 12 by 4, okay, and then if you divide 12, then 4 3s are 12, okay, so your remainder is 0, then you write down here 12 means 4 into 3, so 4 into 3, so your basic formula is like I to the power 4 m, I to the power 4m, because there is no remainder. If there is no remainder, then your answer will be 1. Okay, in the same way you find out like I to the power 21. Okay, you write down I to the power 21, then first you divide 21 by 4, so 4 5s are 20 and the remainder is 1, so you write down like I to the power 4 into 5 and the remainder is 1, so you write down plus 1, so your answer is I. Okay, in the same way you write down all the questions, all questions they are related with the exponent, but the main rule for your any integral power, you divide by 4. If your remainder is 0, then your answer is 1. If your remainder is 1, your answer is I. If your remainder is 2, then answer is minus 1. If your remainder is 3, then you write down minus I. So there are 4 options only. If you have remainder 0, then your answer will be 1. If your remainder is 1, then your answer is I. If your remainder is 2, then answer is minus 1. If your remainder is 3, then your answer is minus I. So now we try the next question, like I to the power 42. Okay, 42, and then divide by 42 4, then I to the power 4 into 10 plus 2. Okay, 42 it means 4 into 10 plus 2. So what is the answer? Because your remainder is 2, and remainder is 2 means answer is minus 1. Similarly, I to the power 53. Okay, so I to the power 53, then I to the power 4 into what? 13, because 13 4s up 52 and 1 is remainder, so your answer is I. And similarly 96, I to the power 96 is there, so we know that I to the power 4 into what? 19 4s are 19 2s are 38, 19 4s are 96. So sorry, 24. So answer is 1. Okay, so in this way you simplify all the integral powers. Like now you have the question 2 because here we have the like larger number. So you try the second part of this question. Your power I like 102. So now you write down 102. So first you divide here 102 divide by 4. 4 2s are 8. Okay, then 2. Bring down 2. 4 5s are. So 20 here, then 2. Okay, so 25 into 2. So you write down here I to the power 4 into 25 plus 2. So answer is minus 1. Similarly, I to the power 113. So again you divide like 113 divide by 4, 4 2s are 8. And then you write down here 3, bring down 3 again. 4 8s are 32. So you write down 32 here, remainder is 1. Okay, so your quotient is 28, so 4 into 28 and remainder is 1, so your answer is I. In the same way, you write down like here I to the power 204, so again you write down same 4 into 51 because 4 into 51 is 204 and now remainder is nothing, so answer is 1. Similarly, 404. Again you write down here 404. So this is 4 into 101. Again no remainder, so answer is 1. 506. Okay, so 506. So 506 you divide with the help of 4, then 4 ones are. So answer, remainder here, bring down 2, 8, 2, then bring down 6, 4 8s are, 32, 4 6 are 24. And 2 remainder. So 4 into 1, 2, 6 plus 2. So answer is minus 1. Okay, so many questions are given in this form because your first exercise of NCERT book or any reference book you try, like Adi Sharma and Anish Agarwal, they are all related with the IOTA. And IOTA, the concept is what only? IOTA, it means you write down IOTA, that is a under root of minus 1. Okay, any value that is given in form of under root minus 1, that is denoted in the form of iota. And now you square it, then I square is minus 1, then I cube is minus I, and I to the power 4 always be 1. So any formula or any integral power we convert into the multiple of 4s. And then we check out our remainder is 0, our remainder is 1, 2 and 3. And then we write down on behalf of the remainder, their answer will be what are the simplified form. So this is very easy concept. Now you try, maybe questions they are in form of like you try like evaluate, suppose. Okay, in this way also maybe 20 plus I to the power 22. Okay, what is the answer of this I to the power 20 and I to the power 22? So first we simplify. What do you mean by I to the power 20? Okay, so first here we convert 20 into multiple of 4. So here we add on 4 into 5 and now similarly same here 4 into 5 but remainder is 2. So what is the answer? Here no remainder, so answer is 1 but here remainder is 2, so your answer is minus 1 and overall simplify our value is 0. So maybe in this type of questions they are in the exercise but their concept and their motto is same. First you simplify your power of iota in multiple of 4s. And then you write down the simplified form and then all simplification you include in the questions and then you write down your answers. So in this slide only here we include the concept of iota. Okay, you do the practice related question with the iota and then we go the further applications like more properties on the complex number. So first in this slide only this much part you revise it. Iota is given here and then powers is given, then how you simplify all properties in this video I explain and then you do the exercise. Okay,